in Centennial Park at this monument to Hermes Toth. It's apparently a monument to rugby, but we'll see that that's only its physical representation and has much deeper meaning. I just want to make a note that this sculpture was commissioned by Sir Henry Parkes, who was the father of Federation, and who was a very high degree Mason, but also a very high degree occultist, as was all of our founding fathers. He was good friends with Edmund Barton, a spiritualist, and anyway, we'll delve into that some other time. I just want to count these rings again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just want to get to that 8 rings around the device. Now, this is, as we said, it's about, meant to be about rugby. You see all of these entities, they don't even look like children. They look like the seraphim, cherubim, order of angels from any iconography has these plumpy figures representing the astral angelic energies. Now, in each of these 4 panels, we have these energies grasp. It's all about this orb above them. The orb's not a circle, it's a footy, which is actually a vesica piscea in 3 dimensions. We've discussed vesica pisceas at Centennial Park before. There's our rectangle again. Here we have one entity's caught the ball. That person's like the avatar. Holding the ball. So in each one of these friezes, a frieze is a 2D, 3D sculptural, and it's called a frieze. Each frieze has a different stage, but then we also have these large catechus figures, large cherubics. Each one of them represents the 4 elements. We know that just by 4, but with closer examination, we see some of the classical things we have here representing Scorpius, the eagle. Scorpio, of course, having the Scorpio, the lizard, and the eagle as its 3 different aspects. Here we have a Taurian figure. And there's like bull's horns, the horns of Moses, all Taurian. Actually, even those hands are describing a Taurian state. Classic leonine. We have the androgynous figure. All of these figures are androgynous, no genitalia, and they're like young children, and that's representing androgyny. We have the hooded lion. So we have Leo, fire. And then we have around here the Ewer, Aquarius. Ewer means water barrier. We have the cup, the horn. So once again, the whole thing's made of brass, which is leaching copper. The copper energy is very strong here in Centennial Park, and I encourage anyone to do a bit further research on what copper represents. I'd like to point out the top knot on top of a Mercury's head. And it's like a spirally top knot. We've just noticed that there are 4 uplights in the 3rd ring. But outside the portal, this one's damaged, but there are 8 nice new LED uplights. It's already been damaged. Now, around, look, it's very interesting that between these 2 rings I've described, we have another pedestal, and 8 of them, 8 lions. The lions are shackled. Now, originally there would have been a chain joining them, but it's the shackles are what's important, actually. The shackles represent the conscious manipulation control of the Masonic New World Order. Us modern shamans, we've unshackled it. We've taken these shackles out to let the lions roar, to activate these energies. We have to remove these shackles and let these lions roar. But the system, the espital, are these shackles. The shackles keep us in these outer rings. When we unshackle and the lions roar, this energy unflowers like a bigger lotus, and then we can enter into the system, and our chakra system joins into the chakra system of the archaeology of the architecture of the sculpture. The architecture of the sculpture symbolizes the architecture of our psychic nature. All of these things are edifices in our psychic being. So it's a meta language showing us how to activate our own energy. But because this is also using a land energy, there is actual its own energy being activated. So when we work spaces like this, our own chakras, i.e. psychic physiology, our psychic organs, which all of this represents, lines up with the psychic organs of the land spirit here. So we can, modern shamans can use these spaces for modern workings. The first thing we do is unshackle. To do that, we unshackle. A Mason is always shackled. Us free, modern, radical, post-Mason occultists, we've taken the shackles off.